After completing the last objective, you should have a Twilio Studio flow responding to one keyword and sending back a default message with instructions on how to use the application. Now, we're going to get a bit more advanced. We'll integrate Twilio functions to execute custom code for different keywords and use Airtable to store RSVPs and SMS subscriptions for our users. We'll provide you with all the code you need, but it will require a bit of work to get it all set up. So, ready to start taking names? Then let's get started. Head out to the Twilio console and navigate to the runtime section. Here, we can create a Twilio function. Twilio functions allow you to host your code on Twilio's infrastructure without worrying about scaling or maintaining your own servers. Twilio functions work great with Twilio Studio, allowing advanced users to write custom code that extends the capabilities of Studio. We'll get started by adding some configuration our functions will need in order to save data in Airtable. In the configuration page for functions, we will add three environment variables. These are values our code will look for while it runs. Type the variable names exactly as shown. Computers are funny in that they need very specific instructions. They always do exactly what we say, though not always what we mean. Of these three variables, the only value we can set right away is the name of the tab that contains our contact information in Airtable. If you followed the example from earlier in the mission, your tab will be named Contacts with a capital C. Next, we'll need to poke around the Airtable interface a bit to find the values for our other configuration parameters. If you're logged into your Airtable account, you should be able to navigate to your account settings page. Here, you'll need to generate or copy an existing Airtable API key. Paste this key into the value field for Airtable API key back in your function configuration. Next, you'll need to copy the unique ID for your Airtable database, which will allow our code to store RSVPs and subscription preferences in the right place. The easiest place to find this value is in the auto-generated API documentation for your Airtable database. Look for a string of text prefixed with app and copy this string to your clipboard. Then, paste this value into the value field for the Airtable database environment variable back in your function configuration. The last piece of configuration we need to do is installing a JavaScript library that makes it easier for our code to interface with the Airtable API. Click the plus button to add a new dependency and enter Airtable as the name of the dependency. This interface can be a little wonky, so you might have to click away from the text field to make the save button light up again. Once you have configured all of your environment variables and our Airtable dependency, make sure to click save one last time before moving on to create a new function. Click the button to add a new function and use the blank template so we can start from pretty much scratch. Give the function a name. You'll be looking for this function name later in Twilio Studio. You should also give the function a URL, but you won't need to use or remember this value for this particular use case. Next, navigate to the GitHub gist URL provided in the notes below this video. View the raw, unstyled version of the code and copy all of it to your clipboard. Back in your function editor, delete all the code that started off in the editor by default and paste in the code from the gist. Once you paste in the code, make sure to hit save. In a few moments, your function code will be deployed and ready to use in Twilio Studio. Now it's time to use our function code in our Twilio Studio flow to store subscription preferences and RSVPs. Drag in a run function widget from the palette on the right and select the Airtable function that we just created. When our function runs, it needs parameters or pieces of data that tells the function what to do. The two parameters we need to pass into the function are the phone number that is texting into our flow and the action we want our function to perform. To insert data from the flow into our function, we need to use the double curly braces and dot notation shown here. This is another part of the interface that can be a little wonky. Make sure that the value for the phone underscore number parameter is trigger.message.from surrounded by opening and closing double curly braces. Click Add Parameter to make sure your parameter configuration is saved. The next parameter is the action we want our function to perform. In this case, we want the function to subscribe the current texter for updates from our organizing team. Now that our function is configured, we need to add a new keyword for our flow to handle. We'll say that when the end user texts the word subscribe, we want to execute this function. If the function executes successfully, we'll send the user a message back telling them that they've been successfully subscribed for updates. After we configure our first new keyword, we have to go through a very similar process to configure the next several keywords. We want to create keywords for unsubscribing, RSVP yes, and RSVP no. Please take note, however, that by default, you can't use the word unsubscribe as one of your application's keywords. Twilio will intercept any such messages before they reach your application, as they indicate a user doesn't want to interact with your application any longer. If you want to handle the unsubscribe keyword yourself, you will need to contact Twilio support first. Our function supports three other action parameters: unsubscribe, RSVP yes, and RSVP no. Let's speed things up a bit and watch these three actions come together. Now that we have all our new keywords configured, we need to update our default message to let end users know that they exist. Let's update that message text now. Once you're finished, make sure to hit publish one last time so that the latest version of your flow is ready to go. Awesome sauce! We're all set to start testing out our new keywords. Let's see how it looks when it all comes together. Great work so far, folks. You're in the home stretch. Complete the challenge for this objective to earn your experience points and get ready to add one more key piece of functionality to your community organizing application. I'd tell you good luck, but by this point, you probably don't need it. We'll see you back here in a minute for the final challenge.